Yes, brother.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My question is it necessary for every Muslim to be a mukhallid? Or what is the status of this practice that everyone should be a Hanafi or Shafi? Is it obligatory or optional or abida?
For the awam, for people who have no knowledge and they are not exposed to the Quran and Sunnah, whatever they do, may Allah forgive them. May Allah guide them. Then at that point of time, they can be a muqallid. Muqallid means blind follower. They just listen what people say and they just follow. But for people who Allah has given you the opportunity to read the Quran, to read the Hadith, to listen to the scholar of Quran and Sunnah, then you should not be a muqallid. You should upgrade yourself and be a muttabi. That means people who follow the religion with an open mind, with knowledge. But if you have not given the chance, that people who live far away in a village, no sheikh go and talk to them, the only people who teach them is their local imam. And whatever the imam said, they believe and they do, Allah will forgive them. They are not committing any sin because they do not know. Yeah. But for people who Allah gives you the chance to know more, you cannot say you do not know. I give you an example. Abu Yusuf, the student of Abu Hanifa. You know, in Hanafi, when you pray, you always only raise up your hand takbir the first time. The rest of the movement, there's no raising up of hand anymore. And this is the practice of the Ahnaf, including Abu Yusuf, the right hand student of Abu Hanifa. But later on, when his teacher passed away, he traveled again and meet other sheikh and learn about the deen. He go deeper and he was been shown by the other sheikh there are so many hadith mutawatir saying that the Prophet raised up his hand when he come up from bowing and raised up his hand before he go to bowing. So Abu Yusuf start to change his stand. So when he met up with other student in the same class with him, the people say, what happened to you, Abu Yusuf? Have you changed your stand? Have you been, now you don't feel, I don't see that you are following the teaching of our great Imam, Abu Hanifa, Nu'man bin Thabit. Then he said, he don't say that his teacher is wrong, no. He said, I do not want to be responsible in the sight of Allah in the Day of Judgment when Allah asks me about the knowledge that I have, the knowledge that I'm exposed to. Now I have seen the hadith said that the Prophet used to raise up his hand not only one time but four times in the prayer. So because of the hadith, I got to change. I don't say that my teacher is wrong, no. Because nobody is perfect. Yeah. If you are not exposed to one thing, this is what you know you do. But later on, if you're being exposed, the hadith is there, is authentic, this is the time you got to make hijrah. You got to upgrade yourself. Because a Muslim, he is always prepared to change for the best. And you must honor and respect all great scholars like Abu Hanifa. He is the teacher of Imam Malik. Malik is the teacher of Shafi'i. And Shafi'i learned hadith from Imam Ahmad. They are all student and teacher. Who are we to say that I follow this, I don't follow that? Astaghfirullah. You don't want to follow Abu Hanifa, you want to follow Shafi'i, you belittle the saying of Shafi'i. Shafi'i's teacher is Maliki. So who are you to belittle Maliki? This is just an example. So don't belittle or don't say that this imam is wrong. No. This is a great imam. There is wajib for us to honor and respect them. But if you are given the right knowledge, you have no right to be a muqallid anymore. But be a muttabi'.